by the New Jerusalem. And the Revelation 21 talks about the New Jerusalem. And one day when this life is over, I want to do that guy John.
Oh, walk in Jerusalem just like John. Walk in Jerusalem just like John. Walk in Jerusalem just like John.
Let me walk
in Jerusalem just like John.
One of these mornings and it won't be long.
You're invited to a gospel roast and birthday celebration for the legendary Jake Cotwell. This is all going to take place Saturday, May 25th, 6 to 10 p.m. at the Sammy Congo Social Hall, located in the Eason Fair Baptist Church, 1400 B Street, with the Dr. Christopher Bullock, where the Dr. Christopher Carey is the pastor. Music by the Mighty Men of the Canyon Baptist Church, where Dr. Christopher Allen Bullock is the pastor. Also music by the Gospel Ambassador. This is a catered affair. Tickets are only $20. For tickets and information, call Marva Richardson Roy at 302-261-6107. And if you want to participate in the roasting of Jake Cotwell, give your truly George Wisher a call at 762-3249. This is sponsored by From the Heart TV Show, where Marva Richardson Roy is the host. Don't forget, gospel roast and birthday celebration for the legendary Jake Cotwell, Saturday, May the 25th, 6 to 10 p.m. at the Sammy Congo Social Hall, located at Eason Fair Baptist Church, where the Dr. Christopher Carey is the pastor. Be there.
I'm Marva Richardson, and I'm so excited. I love these events, and I thank you so much for just jumping in with me. You know, when we had these, you know, little ideas, and if we didn't have the backup behind us, like Mr. Witcher, it wouldn't be an event, and all the ones that you see sitting on the train. So again, we are delighted. Mr. Cotwell is a wonderful person, and I can't forget that when my brother-in-law, Pastor Jerry Richardson, had an event, even though Mr. Cotwell, I knew that he was going to and fro doing different things, he jumped right on board, didn't hesitate, did he?
No,
never forgot that. And I wanted this to be a very, very special event. I wanted him to know how much we appreciate him, how much we love him, and how much we as the train members are to get together and make this a very, very special day for him. And Mr. Witcher, without you, I couldn't, you know, because Mr. Witcher knows. He's been knowing Mr. Cotwell for years and years. He knows exactly what to do, how to do it. And you know, without him on board instructing me and being the engineer, he is the engineer for this event, it wouldn't be. So I thank you so much. Before we go to our very, very special guest, is there anything else you want to say in regards to this?
Well, first of all, we give honor to God and for allowing us to be here today. We want to thank you, Marva, for the tremendous work that you've done down through the years in the community, giving of yourself, your time, and your money to reach out to impact the human conditions in our community. So we thank you for that. But when you called me about doing something for Jay, and then naturally being a program coordinator and also the booking manager for the group for some 30 plus years, you know, I was more than delighted to jump in and do whatever we could. And I thought and I thought and I prayed about it, and God laid it on my heart, let's do a gospel roast. You know, Jay loved to joke and kid with everybody. I don't care where you see him at, that's his spirit. So we're going to put him on the hot seat, you know, and we're excited about it. I mean, we're giving the community an opportunity to come and say thank you. If someone dies and people's families, they call on Jay, he don't hesitate. If he's available, he'll come, and he won't accept one penny to sing. So this is our time to come back and say, Jay, you know, we thank you for all that you have done, you know, and we thank you, Marva, you know, for thinking about Jay. And it's going to be an awesome affair. Now, you know, tickets are limited. I've called people out of state who's going to participate, who's going to come in. We're excited about the Mighty Men of Canaan for the Canaan Baptist Church, where Dr. Christopher Allen Bullock is the pastor. They're going to be singing. Also, the gospel ambassadors will be singing. A full course catered meal by Neats, and all of this here for only $20. I'm excited.
Yes, so am I. And I just, like I said, I don't want to keep talking because I've talked too much. I'm at the point now where I'm a little emotional. I get this way now. But before we go any further and bring our guest on, I want to say to LAPA, Josie, are you back?
Yes, I am.
We miss Josie. I wanted to thank LAPA, which is, like I said, the background of us. You know, we can't do anything. In other words, when you see me and all the producers, whoever, that come before the camera, we had that foundation, which is LAPA. Without LAPA, there would be no us. Without LAPA, there would be no outlet for us to do these things that we do. And you know, like I said, there are outreaches in other areas, but this is the greatest outreach that we could possibly have, and through LAPA we're able to do this. So I will gratefully, gracefully bow to you and thank you with all of my heart, LAPA, for making it happen. With that, I want to introduce the guests. I want to give them time to you know, for their input. I thank Mr. Tony for coming down. It's been a long time, but you're still a train member. But we want to go from Josie to one of my favorites. You know how I talk about this man all the time, Mr. Samuel L. Guy. He's with us today, as well as Linwood Jackson. So without me saying any more, and I'll talk more about other things. First of all, I'd like to talk about Ms. Till Petty that couldn't be with us. She lost her niece, and she's running for councilwoman, I think. What is that, in Newcastle? Mm-hmm. We do give our condolences out to her. We give our condolences out to Mr. Lance Bruce, who lost his aunt last week. And for all of you that are going through challenges in your life of a lost loved one or just different things you're going through, know that you have us in the background. For my mother that's looking on, keep on trucking, Mom. She's rolling around in the car now.
Right.
My mother's dangerous. So I'm going to let this go, Josie, and then I'm going to let you introduce the others.
Well, first of all, Marva, and to the community out there, thank you so much. It's good to be back. I have been quite busy, so that's why I haven't been here, but Marva keeps up with me. She calls me and finds out where I am. But it's good to be back, and it's good to be back with the panel sitting here. Before I go any further, you were talking about thanking LAPA, and as we were sitting, Mr. Sam Guy reminded us that LAPA just didn't start 5 years ago, that it was years, it's history. And we want to thank Mr. George Witcher, who at the time, some 35 years ago, was the president of LAPA, who made for sure at that time that Channel 28 was not taken off the air. So we want to thank you and all those back then that continue to make sure that we continue to be here and stay on the air. And now as we move forward, we want to thank the present president and all those that are involved now to make sure that we are continuing to make sure that Channel 28 stays here on the air. So thanks to Ms. Ruth Baker, thanks to everyone, because if it wasn't from the support of everyone, none of us would be sitting here. So down through the years, Mr. Guy, as you said, is history. And we thank you because you're part of that history. You helped to make sure that things were done to make sure that Channel 28 continued on. So we just want to give thanks to everyone. And as you say, Mr. Witcher, we need to give thanks while people are living. They can enjoy, their fruits of their labor, what they have already done. So again, thanks to everyone. I'm glad your mom's doing well. That's good to hear. And I just want to do my little spill, Marva, and because I know we have other guests. But I just want to say that I am a member of CBTU, and I was at that meeting on yesterday, our meeting. And there was a young lady by the name of Adriana Baum, who was running for a board member for the Red Clay School District. As she presented herself and talked about, her degrees and her involvement with education, and after listening to Brittingham this morning, I just thought they had a wonderful, wonderful program. Education is very, very important. And to this young lady who is running for a board member, I just thought that since CBTU endorsed her yesterday, I just wanted to make sure that the community knows that to find out about her, but I'm going to give you a little bit of information. And I think she's well qualified, and she would be just a good person that would be on the board, that would be concerned about our kids and about education. Now, let me tell you a little bit about her. Adriana, she went to Warner Elementary. She was bused to Stanton Middle School, and she graduated high school from Dickinson. After high school, she graduated from the University of Delaware with a BA. She got her master's degree in sociology from the University of Maryland, and then she got her doctorate from Temple University in Philadelphia. Apart from getting educated at Temple University, she was the main organizer of Teachers Assistant Union at Temple University. She is now an associate professor of sociology at Delaware County Community College. She is married. Her husband works at the Marriott in Philadelphia, and she has two children. And her children go to Highland Elementary School in Wilmington. She has been endorsed by the Teachers Union in Wilmington and the UAW Retirees Chapter of Local 435, and yesterday she was endorsed by CBTU. Find more about Adriana. You know, one, she told a little story yesterday. She said after she had went to college one year, and she came home, and she was looking for a job. She said her mother apparently worked at GM, and she went to GM, and she had a summer job, and she was making $25 an hour. $25 an hour is pretty good money. She said to her mother, "Well, Mom, I don't think I'm going back to college." She said, "Because this is good money I'm making." She said her mother said to her, "It's not about the money. It's about being educated." And that's where we are today. It's about educating our children, and I think she would be just one of the best persons that would be a board member that would look after the welfare of our children and education. So I just say personally, this is not from the heart. This is from Josie Roy. Like I always sit here and do, I personally do what I think that's right for me. And I do endorse Adriana. And as I said, CBTU endorsed her yesterday. So look out for the different, the election is May 14th, and you can vote from 10 a.m. until 8 p.m. on the day of the election. There is a lot of polling places, but if you're in the Red Clay District, make sure that you go to one of those schools in that district and vote. And I just have one more announcement, and that's you're invited to attend a happy hour fundraiser hosted by the CBTU Friday, April the 19th at Timothy's on the riverfront from 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. The tickets are $25, a table of 10, $250, and you can contact Faith Morris 302-290-9525 or Diana Russ 302-494-5037. Anytime you belong to an organization, you have to have funds. So this is a fundraiser for CBTU. A lot of you come to our meetings, were endorsed and have won elections because of CBTU. So we're asking you now to be a part, support our happy hour fundraiser on April the 19th, 5 to 7 at Timothy's on the riverfront.
Could you read the next commercial that I gave you?
Oh, okay. And one more. We want to make sure that you go out to Greater St. John. The pastor is Reverend Drewy L. Richardson. It's Family and Friends Day. I've been there before. Great, great service and a great, great pastor. That's April the 28th, 11 a.m. And the guest speaker is Pastor Troy Johnson for the morning service. So please go out and support these events. And thank you so much, Marva. And thank you.
Now, before
wonderful guests I'm sitting here with.
Before I go any further, and I want Mr. Garwin, all these. Now, Mr. Linwood, we got to keep a hold on it because they got a lot they got to get out. Mr. Linwood, don't look at me like that. I'm just teasing. I like to tease him. But listen, I want you to personally thank the pastor of Pastor Carey. Yes. For allowing us, so we can get these thoughts in our mind or these ideas in our mind. But if people don't give consent, they could have said no. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Even though Mr. Codwell is a member, you know, and I'm delighted that it's in the Sammy Congo Social Hall. But I want you to personally thank him from my heart for allowing us to come in. And I, you know, I'm just grateful. So, Mr., is there anything else? Because I know he wants to run out on us. Are you going to stay a little while longer?
Oh, no, I told my wife that I'd be home soon, so I'm going to come on and make my announcement. But we're going to have more information out there. And like I said, the tickets are limited. Also, you know, I would like to thank my pastor, Dr. Christopher Allen Bullock, for allowing the mighty men of Canaan to come and sing and to participate. And, you know, when you call me, then I pick up the phone and I start calling my contacts. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it's not me. I'm the one that's out front. But, you know, I call Doc Henry, who's the treasurer and president and founder of the Gospel Ambassadors, Keith Yancey, who's the music director, and others, mm-hmm. right, so that we can put this here together and make sure that it's going to be a class act affair. It's going to be a beautiful affair, beautifully catered. Food is good. The service is good, and we're just going to have a good time, and we're going to show our appreciation to a man that gives up himself all the time, you know, to give God the praise and the glory and put himself out to help others.
You know, I was teasing Mr. Witcher. I, you know, called him. He'll hear a lot of me. You know them long-winded messages. And I was saying, you know, Mr. Codwell does so much.
Yes, he does.
And I know sometimes he gets weary and tired like all of us do. And I was saying to Mr. Witcher, you know, you can just let him know. He sings the song, Moses, Take Your Shoes Off. I love that song. And Mr. Witcher cut me down, though. I said, Mr. Witcher, you can tell Mr. Codwell that night he don't even have to come in with no shoes on. I'm saying, let him be relaxed. I know you all think I'm crazy, but I said, just let him chill out and relax. Mr. Witcher cut that down.
Oh, no.
He said, no. He wasn't going, no.
What he ain't coming in there with no shoes.
But what did you tell me? What did you tell me, Mr. Witcher?
Well, as far as Jay and doing things in a classy way, and, you know, not that it wouldn't be, but, you know, it's an affair that, you know, we want to come out dressed to impress.
That's what he said. Right. Yes. You know, and I didn't mean no harm, Josie.
Oh, I
knew everybody would come in with shoes, but I said if we really get that out, there probably people come in bare feet and all, you know, so dressed.
Shorty shorts.
Oh, please. Yes. Yes.
Daisy Duke.
Oh, my God. We can't have that now. We got to kind of chill out a little bit.
Just to impress. Just to,
now, like I said, and thank you for being the engineer. And Mr. Codwell, if you're listening, you'll be very, very proud of, because I was joking with him a couple years ago, and I said, he teases me about you so much. And I said, Mr. Codwell, will you do me a favor? He says, for you, I will. I said, don't fire Mr. Witcher. Yeah, that's supposed to be a joke.
But look, it's payback time now.
No. Yes, yes.
Now he's going to be on the hot seat.
Yes, yes. I'm going to love that night. Yes.
Yeah, I am. I'm looking forward to it.
So, anyhow, we're going to take a very, very short break. When we come back, we're going to give Mr. Witcher time to, you know, chill out and go to his wife. Mm-hmm. And then we'll be right back. Please stay tuned.
Thank you, Mom.
Is it all right? Y'all give us a big hand clap if it's all right. Oh, we just getting warmed up. We just getting warmed up in here. Great God Almighty. There's a song. You know, I feel pretty good. We used to sing a song we wrote a few years ago. Mark 10:46 talked about the fact that Jesus was leaving Jericho. But a little bit of this now. We were leaving Jericho, going.
Oh.
Good afternoon. I'm Marva Richardson once again, and I'm again delighted to be here with you. And I know my mother's watching me, and I want to make her proud of me. And I use this proud because I want to bring Mr. Samuel L. Guy on, and we're going to talk with the others, you know, about, you know, what they've, you know, it's a lot of things they want to get out. But, you know, I looked at a while back, a few weeks ago, Mr. Sammy Congo. I watch all the shows faithfully, and there was a video they did of the Judge Leonard Williams. Mm. And I was so impressed with Mr. Williams. He talked about his children. He talked about, I think there were nine, they showed the picture. And he talked about how they made up their mind they were going to stick together. He also talked about the fact that how proud they were of one another. Mm-hmm. And it made me think, why can't we as a people, even as me, my family, families per se, why can't we be proud of one another? Why can't, no matter what indifferences we have, why can't we just say it's kid stuff and, you know, get over it? And the moments that count are the moments that are here, you know. And Josie, you know, we've been going through a lot of things, and I've been telling people, my family, families all over, let us not wait until something happens that we look down when we can look up. When we keep anger within us, we are robbing ourselves of joy. We are causing ourselves to have strokes, heart attacks, different things by just not, you know, I speak a lot of this on forgiveness. Why can't we forgive and let it out and let it go? One thing I'm going to say to a friend of our family, Miss Sarah Ash, how Miss Sarah Ash took the time to go see my mother last week and spent a couple hours with her. And I know there are people that would be delighted to do that, as Mr. Linwood Jackson went down. But why can't we forget these petty things? You know, there's only one, I think about your mother, Miss Gloria Roy. Wouldn't it be so nice just to have her with us? I loved your mother.
Sure would.
She was not only Josie's mother, she was my mother. Mm-hmm. She acted as a role for my mother. My mother's still here. Why can't we take this moment and forget all this crazy stuff and get on board and do what we're supposed to do? And I'm saying that again. People are saying, they might say, well, she's throwing us out again. I'm going to throw it out until I see results, because it's, you know, it's what we need to do. Mr. Samuel Guy, we're going to bring you on. Your mother, his mother and father, they're still with us, aren't they? And they're spry and, you know, and Mr. Samuel Guy, when I saw him, we did an event for Mr. Guy during this summer when he was running for, you know, office. And they came in, they're so spry and so full of energy. And you could see how Mr. Guy was proud of his parents. We're going to bring you on now, Mr. Guy, so you can talk with us and just keep the others rolling.
It's pretty interesting. Thank you for having me here today. And it's interesting, as you mentioned, and we were sitting around last weekend, my mom, my dad, and my brother, and my dad started talking about his life, which he does all the time. He did it since I was a little kid. He would tell stories. He's a storyteller. And he was telling the story how back in fourth or fifth grade, he went to the grand opening of the SPCA on A Street, and he recited something on behalf of the number 29 school there on the east side that's been torn down, and how that teacher, Miss Foreman, always had him going somewhere giving presentations on behalf of the school, and he hated it that she always was messing with him, making him do this. And later in life, he learned that she was trying to help develop him. He ended up being a school teacher, retired school teacher. But it was just an interesting story, because I've driven by that SPCA location for my whole lifetime, and I never knew he was at the actual dedication of it back in fourth or fifth grade. And he's 83 now. Mm-hmm. But that's the power of a teacher, to push children to be all that they can be. Now, my mom and dad went to school with Judge Williams. They all are part of that Howard High School crew. I call it the group of people. That's a special group of people, the old school Howard High School graduate. So I always tell people, jokingly, but I'm serious, whatever's good about me, I attribute it to my mom and dad, and whatever it is that's wrong with me, that's all my fault. But having said that, there's a picture that I would like everybody to see, and then I'm gonna make these brief comments regarding Judge Williams' sign. And back in 1997, when I was a council person, I had a law passed requiring a deed restriction put in place so that whoever bought this piece of land from the city, if they ever built a courthouse on it, it would have to be named the Leonard L. Williams Justice Center. Now, I said that was 1997. I was born in 59, so I was 38. So at age 38, I knew that Judge Leonard L. Williams was a major significant figure in the history of Delaware and knew that that he should be recognized for such back then. It's now from 1997, we're now in 2013. He recently passed. And what happened in between is that the state ended up buying this land from the city, but there's a deed restriction requiring that if anybody ever built a courthouse, it would have to be named the Leonard L. Williams Justice Center. So it's time that that takes place. Now, I've been raising this issue for multiple years, and so I was very happy to read in the newspaper that the Wilmington City Council, the current city council, is supporting what the previous city council in 1997 put into law, and they're calling on the state to honor that law in 97 that we had passed and the deed restriction that was put in place, and they're saying to the state, why haven't you done your part? So I was very happy to see the city of Wilmington City Council act on that. It was funny to see the News Journal write the article as if this is something that's brand new that just happened this week, when it's something that's in law. So there's always a history to everything, just as Josie was pointing out, mm-hmm. Reverend Witcher, as the previous president of LAPA. Everything has a history. Life's not a photograph, it's a moving picture. And if you don't see the whole movie, you won't know the whole story. And various people, unlike Josie, who wants you to understand the whole history and the whole story, sometimes people like the News Journal, they only want you to see what happened today, mm-hmm. so that you don't get the full understanding of the egregiousness of what hasn't taken place since 1997. So that was a visual image. That sign doesn't exist, but I created it using technology and put it on a post using technology in Wilmington so that you could see what ought to be throughout the city of Wilmington. Because all of you have seen signs that look just like that, that say Lawyers Row and has everybody's name in the world on signs. But since 1997, there's been no mayor yet who's had Public Works put those signs up. They should have been up since 1997. And the state hasn't put his name on the building and built the things that are supposed to be put in place, the plaques and all of that kind of stuff in conjunction with this. So this is gonna play out. But here's the point I want to make. How can a court system own a court building where people come in every day from all over Delaware and they send them to jail and make decisions that people have to pay money and do all kind of things to people for not following the law, when the state of Delaware itself is not following the law in putting up the appropriate recognition of Judge Williams? That's a serious issue that the state of Delaware is going to have to look in the mirror, the people who lead it and run it, and ask themselves, what is it that makes us not honor the recognition for this man, but we do all of these things to people every day that come in this building? But this is going to play out, but we're going to learn about whether the law applies to everybody and whether justice is for everybody. And I'm so happy that in 97, when I authored this ordinance, that I didn't say Leonard L. Williams Courthouse. I wanted it named the Leonard L. Williams Justice Center, because he was about justice. And I'm just happy that was the word that was chosen. And then in wrapping up, Jay Caldwell, I can't wait to go to this event. As a little child, you mentioned the room named after Sammy Congo. Well, there's another room over at Ezon Fair Baptist Church named after my grandmother. Because she was on the motherboard and she was the person who headed up the Bracey specials, Clara Bracey. Everybody at Ezon from back in the day knows her. She used to bring kids in all the time. But Ezon Fair was the singingest church ever. And Jay Caldwell used to perform in Ezon Fair. And when I was a little bitty kid, he used to sing. And you had people like Linda Henry was out of Ezon Fair, and there's others. And so I'm just so happy that this is taking place, because what happens is a person can travel all about around the world and be recognized and invited, but there's nothing like the people where you live who want to reach out and give you a hug and recognize you. And this is going to mean the world to Jay. And so I'm so glad that you're providing this leadership.
I thank you for all of your support, because without all of us together, it wouldn't be. Thank you. And well, we're not done with you yet, but I want to give Linwood and Mr. Tony. Mr. Tony, I want to thank you so much, because we've been trying to get him on. And I said to myself last night, you know what I think I'm going to do? I'm going to ride down to the club. But I got busy. I had to do an account in Middletown, mm-hmm. one of our, you know, the accounts I had. Mm-hmm. And it took me like 4 hours to do that account. And by the time I got home, I was tired. Mm-hmm. Right. But thank you. But I was going to rope you in. We thank you so much for your input and what you do for the community and your business and your food. And we also thank him. We know he bought us some food. Now, you guys can't go nowhere today. You got to kind of chill a little bit and have something to eat. But we just thank you for your support and all that you do. And that's why we want to give you time to, after you talk, and Mr. Jackson, let's give him a good interview so we can all kind of mingle a little bit, because I need at least 5 minutes to close.
Absolutely. First off, I want to thank Mr. Sam Guy for that great history lesson that he mm-hmm. just shared with us. I tell you, I'm fascinated every time I speak with Sam. You know, we're going back ways. We worked together on a few occasions, and I love hearing his historical perspective and hearing him share these stories of history with me. I'm all ears when I'm listening to Sam Guy. He spoke about his father's experiences at Howard High School, what was then the only African-American high school in the state, from what I understand. Today we were talking about that. We're talking about educating our kids and making sure that they get the tools they need to survive in this world. I also want to feed off of Josie, what she was saying earlier about the Christina School District having their board member vote for the board members. Is that correct? And she touched on Miss Adriana. And I don't know her personally, but she's being endorsed by the United Auto Workers Retirees, and I happen to be a United Auto Worker Retiree. She's also being endorsed by the Coalition of Black Trades Union, which I happen to be a proud member of as well. So if they're backing this young lady, then I have to lend my full support as well, because they're definitely in the news right now for disproportionately kicking our kids out of school, and for no reason, all this kind of mess going on in there. I know the Mayor Williams is working on that, as well as Newcastle County Executive Tom Gordon, Jay Street, and a whole host of other politicians, religious leaders, civil rights leaders as well. So I'm advocating and pushing and hoping that they all come out and support our leaders who's taking the lead on correcting this issue. We can't just stand by, close eyes, and watch these our leaders fall by the wayside once they speak out on something so important. Definitely lend my support there. At this time, I would like to introduce a friend of mine who's running a great establishment over in Celebrations on Market. He is the co-owner and chef of Celebrations on Market, and they call it your one-stop shop for partying until you drop. And I'll tell you right now, I do my best to get mine in. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm pleased to welcome my friend, Mr. Tony Williams. Tony, how you doing, man?
I'm doing well. Thanks for having me. Thank you, Marva. It's always a pleasure to come on at your behest. We are really enjoying our opportunity that was given to us with Celebrations on Market. It is a one-stop shop. Not everyone parties until they drop, but Linwood does a pretty good job of it.
I'm trying.
He's the dancing king. Between him and George Evans, I don't know who cha-chas or bops better. That's a shout out to you, George. George is a loyal customer, and he's supported us for a long time, as well as Linwood. Is there anything in particular that you wanted to talk about Celebrations?
Well, yeah. Can you fill us in on what you got going on there new? I know you guys are working on, you have a deck out there that's just fabulous. You have plenty of parking. It's right there on the main street, has access to everybody. Any projects you plan on working on in the future?
Well, we're working on the building continuously. We're rehabbing that. I'm getting ready to start working on the deck with some beautification projects for that. We just want to supply something that's very nice and intimate for people who enjoy a semi-large environment. You know, we can't fit 1,000 people on our deck, but I always tell them, let them have their 500, give us our 50. And we're continually promoting our Thursday and Friday nights, which is the two nights that we are open to the public. Thursday nights is an international night, and on international night, we call it Spice Up Your Thursdays, and we play a wide variety of music at the facility for that. Happy hours from 5 to 7. The first 25 people in the door get a complimentary appetizer, chef's choice, and the music that you would hear during that time is African, Brazilian, salsa, European. It's just a wide blend of things, Haitian Creole. What I like to do is expose people to different experiences, and you learn a lot through cultures by the music, and it's beginning to become very successful. That's followed by salsa dancing and reggae afterwards. We give free salsa lessons every Thursday night. Fernando with One Latin Nation is helping us push this and promote it. It's a wonderful time. It's a wonderful time. If you like to do something that's different, not the norm, come and check us out. And of course, every Friday is dinner and old school dancing.
Yeah, that's right. You have a restaurant there as well.
Yes.
And so we're talking about education, and I'm always talking about broadening your horizons and expanding your territory. If you come out to celebrations, sound like you're going to learn a whole lot of stuff right there. Dance, you're learning language and all kind of food you're offering. And you said, did you say free buffet?
We took the buffet out because there's some very, very hungry people out there.
<I can imagine. laughs>
So what we did was we give them a complimentary appetizer. The first 25 people in the door. Last Thursday, they had a choice of a Cuban pulled pork taco or a grilled chicken taco.
May I ask them a question? My daughter fixes a mean pulled pork because we had that as one of the, you know, foods at one of the events, and it was, they just wanted more and more and more. We didn't make enough of it. Explain to me, and for the viewers who might not know, what does that consist of?
Pulled pork is simply, you roast the product, mm-hmm. You slow roast it for about 4 hours, and instead of cutting it, you pull it off and you shred it off. So that's where the term pulled pork comes from. We use a Cuban recipe. Mm-hmm. I've lived in Florida, and I've had chance to travel the Caribbean to Mexico, mm-hmm. and I've learned to appreciate a lot of different flavors. I'm originally from North Carolina, mm-hmm. So I grew up on Southern cuisine. Mm-hmm. So our food, our menu represents Southern, Creole, Afro-Caribbean, and Latino-Caribbean. So you get the gamut there. And actually, we brought some food for you to try today.
I know.
And you'll get to meet my right hand in the kitchen. Yes. And her name is Jessie.
Yes.
And her and I went in right before we came in and prepared this food for you. I just say one thing?
Sure.
I can't do any of this by myself. So
yes.
Patricia, Tracy Brown, mm-hmm. Suzette, who is better known as Q, Vernon, who provides security, Gary James, who's our pastry chef for special events, and he helps me with banquets, and all the rest of the staff at celebrations, we really can't do it without them.
I've got to jump in on this, Mr. Linwood, and I want to let you talk, but I want to get Mr. Sam Guy on for final moments and whatever. I need somebody for this Mr. Codwell event to make me a Mr. J. Codwell birthday cake.
Now that is Gary James.
We've got the menu to get. Are you serious?
Gary James.
All right then, Mr. Gary James, I want you to commit him. I want a nice birthday. I want it, and we're expecting at least 300 people off the bat.
Wow.
I need a big cake. Can he roll that cake?
I am going to reach out to Gary. Gary is known as Chef Samaj.
Yes.
And he's wonderful. He's met Gary. He's well known for his desserts in the area.
Okay.
He does a lot of personal chef work.
Yes.
And I'm very fortunate that Gary comes in and allows me to take advantages of his services there.
Well, I'm committed. This is a commitment. And let me know what he needs and whatever. But it's got to be a cake that will at least. And we're going to have something to go with it. But I was just kind of tossing in my mind, who could I get to do the cake? Mm-hmm. That's it.
He will not disappoint.
I believe that. Because you won't. Okay. Let me ask all of you.
I want to know what he brought to share with us today.
None of your business. You just got to wait. You're too greedy.
Mr.
Now, you know he's another greedy one. When he probably was the one eating up all the hors d'oeuvres, wasn't he? He's not saying in.
Well, it, you know, in fairness to the food, Chef Jessie does that Latino blend buffet for me, and if she wasn't doing such a good job, they wouldn't have been eating so much of it.
Right.
So, and I don't know when we're going to bring Chef Jessie in, but shout out to Jessie. She is a wonderful young lady. She's a part of the Latino community here, and I just think the world of
her. Listen, and why I don't want to miss this because time goes by so fast. I want to commit all of you. And Mr. Guy, I got on the phone to Mr. Guy. He doesn't get back with me, but he told me to just let him know here he is. I'm gonna be back on the phone again. I want you here next week. I want you here. I want you to help me with all your heart. And I know you will, Mr. Guy, because I need all of you to help me make this event, not only with this event, but with what you've got to offer. All of you've got so much to offer the viewers out there. I just want you to be a part of me. Can I commit to you? And I know Mr. Ben was gonna be here. You and Josie, I know you're not taking off next Sunday.
Most definitely. Let me say a few words here, Marva, to Tony. Mm-hmm. I just want to say and commend him, because I know during the campaign a lot of us were down after the election was over, and it was kind of my first time being there. I just want to say commend you for the environment. I went in and I was so pleased how everything was there and the hospitality. I thought it was great. So I just want to say, to people to go down and support what you're doing down there. It's great. It's wonderful. And the atmosphere was just wonderful when we were all down there. And let me say to Mr. Guy, during the election, Mr. Guy was always sitting in the seat, seems like next to me. But I just want to say to him, I heard what Linwood said. You know, when he talks, it's like he just gets your attention, because he just speaks so much of the truth. And what he talks about, it's so important. And I just want to say to him, thank you, Mr. Guy, for everything that you have done. You have done some work in this city, in this state, that probably nobody else would have ever thought of doing. You're working now and doing things out with the county, with County Exec Tom Gordon. Hats off to you, and thank you for whatever you're doing. I don't know what you do, but I know whatever you're a part of, that is good and is well worthwhile. But I just need to say that to him and to Linwood. I just want to say to Linwood, I appreciate you, Linwood. I sat at home today and listening at the Brittingham Chronicles, and just to hear all the dialogue that was going on about the education, all the topics and issues that you bring up that's concerning our community, and how dire it is for us to become involved. And I heard Denise say that, people say that they don't know how to become involved. But you can even look at Channel 28 all day long, and there is somebody on Channel 28 that touches you, that you can go to,